Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. This is lecture number 4.7 in the module PERT CPM. The topic for today's discussion is CPM computations and identifying critical path in the network. The learning outcome to the students: at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to find the critical path of the CPM network. So we take example number 10. Draw the network for the following data and determine the free float, slacks and the critical path and the project duration. There are activities 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 5, 2, 8, 3, 6, 4, 6, 4, 7, 5, 8, 6, 8, 6, 9, 7, 9, 8, 10, 9, 10. The duration of each activity, duration in days for each activity are 6, 3, 5, 4, 5, 7, 4, 6, 3, 4, 3, 2, 6, 5. So the network is drawn. So the network for the project work is shown here, and the earliest expected time, latest allowable time and the slack values are calculated and are printed in the diagram. Now we use the forward pass computation to verify the earliest expected time. So for the first event, the TE value is 0. So in the circle of the event, the top above, in the top the event number is shown, left bottom the TE value is shown and right bottom the TL value is shown. So TE value, earliest expected time of the initial event, is set to 0. TE2, there is only one incoming arrow, TE2 equal to TE1 plus TE12, 0 plus 6 equal to 6. TE3, there is only one incoming arrow, TE1 plus TE13 equal to 0 plus 3 equal to 3. TE4, there is only one incoming arrow, TE1 plus TE14 equal to 0 plus 5 equal to 5. And TE5, there is only one incoming arrow, TE2 plus TE25 equal to 6 plus 4 equal to 10. TE6 equal to maximum of TE3 plus TE36 equal to 3 plus 7 equal to 10 and TE4 plus TE46 equal to 5 plus 4 equal to 9. So the maximum value is 10, and TE7, so 7, there is only one incoming arrow, TE7 equal to TE4 plus TE47, 5 plus 6 equal to 11. TE8, there are 3 incoming arrow, TE2 plus TE28 equal to 6 plus 5 equal to 11. TE5 plus TE58 equal to 10 plus 3 equal to 13, and TE6 plus TE68 10 plus 4 equal to 14. So the maximum value is 14. 14 is the TE value. TE9 equal to maximum of TE6 plus TE69 is equal to 10 plus 3 equal to 13, and TE7 plus TE79 equal to 11 plus 2 equal to 13. TE10 equal to maximum of TE8 plus TE810 equal to 14 plus 6 equal to 20, and TE9 plus TE910 equal to 13 plus 5 equal to 18. So the maximum value is 20. So all the TE values are shown here. Then TL value. So using the backward pass computation, we calculate the latest allowable occurrence time. So the TL value of the 10th event is fixed to 20. So TL10 equal to TE10 equal to 20. TL9, so this is only one outgoing arrow, TL9 equal to TL10 minus TE910 equal to 20 minus 5 equal to 15. So 15 is the time here. TL8, there is only one outgoing arrow, TL10 minus TE810 equal to 20 minus 6 equal to 14. 20 minus 6 equal to 14. And TL6, there are two outgoing arrow, minimum of TL9 minus TE69. So 15 minus 3 equal to 12. And the TL8 minus TE68 equal to 14 minus 4 equal to 10. So the minimum value is 10 here. Then TL5. So TL5, there is only one outgoing arrow. TL8 minus TE58 equal to 14 minus 3 equal to 11. TL4, there are two outgoing arrow. TL7 minus TE47 equal to 13 minus 6 equal to 7. And the TL6 minus TE46 equal to 10 minus 4 equal to 6. The minimum value is 6 here. TL3 equal to TL6 minus TE36 equal to 10 minus 7 equal to 3. So 3 here. TL2 is minimum of TL2, there is two outgoing arrow, minimum of TL5 minus TE35 equal to 11 minus 4 equal to 7, TL8 minus TE28 equal to 14 minus 5 equal to 9, the minimum value is 7, and TL1, minimum of TL4 minus TE14 equal to 6 minus 5 equal to 1, TL3 minus TE13 equal to 3 minus 3 equal to 0, TL2 minus TE12 equal to 7 minus 6 equal to 1. So, the minimum value is 0. And then the slack values are calculated. So, slack value is the difference between TL minus TE value. So, 0 minus 0 equal to 0, 3 minus 3 equal to 0, 6 minus 7 equal to 1, 6 minus 5 equal to 1, 13 minus 11 equal to 2, 10 minus 10 equal to 0, 11 minus 10 equal to 1, 14 minus 14 equal to 0, 20 minus 20 equal to 0, 15 minus 13 equal to 2. So, for the event 1, 3, 6, 8 and 10, the event slack equal to 0, they are the critical event. All the other event can be delayed by the slack value, and the critical path is 1, 3, 6, 8, 10. Now, the critical path is 1, 3, 6, 8, 10 and the project duration is 20 days. So, using the CPM network, CPM calculation, we will identify the critical path. So, the float and the total float and the free float calculation of the entire project work is shown here. The jobs are 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4, 2 to 5, 2 to 8, 3 to 6, 4 to 6, 4 to 7, 5 to 8, 6 to 8, 6 to 9, 7 to 9, 8 to 10, 9 to 10. And the TEIJ value given in the network, ESI equal to TEI, which is 0, 0, 0, 6, 0, 3, 5, 5, 10, 10, 10, 11, 14, 13, what we calculated earlier. LCJ equal to TLJ, 7, 3, 6, 11, 14, 10, 10, 13, 14, 14, 15, 15, 20, 20. And LSIJ equal to LCJ minus TEIJ. So, LCJ is the fourth column minus the second column. 7 minus 6 equal to 1, 3 minus 3 equal to 0, 6 minus 5 equal to 1, 11 minus 4 equal to 7, 14 minus 5 equal to 9, 10 minus 7 equal to 3, 10 minus 4 equal to 6, 13 minus 7 equal to 7, 13 minus 6 equal to 7, 14 minus 3 equal to 11, 14 minus 4 equal to 10, 15 minus 3 equal to 12, 15 minus 2 equal to 13, 20 minus 6 equal to 14, and 20 minus 5 equal to 15. Then ECIJ, which is ESI plus TEIJ, ESI is the third column and the second column, adding these two, 0 plus 6, 6, 0 plus 3, 3, 0 plus 5, 5, 6 plus 4, 10, 6 plus 5, 11, 3 plus 7, 10, 4 plus 5 plus 9, 5 plus 4, 9, 5 plus 6, 11, 10 plus 3, 13, 10 plus 4, 14, 10 plus 3, 13, 11 plus 2, 13, 16 plus 4, 20, 13 plus 5, 18. Then total float is the difference between LSIJ minus ESI. So, LSIJ is the fifth column and third column. So, 1 minus 1 equal to 0, 0 minus 0 equal to 0, 1 minus 0 equal to 1, 7, 7 minus 6 equal to 1, 9 minus 6 equal to 3, 3 minus 3 equal to 0, 6 minus 5 equal to 1, 7 minus 5 equal to 2, 11 minus 10 equal to 1, 10 minus 10 equal to 0, 12 minus 10 equal to 2, 13 minus 11 equal to 2, 14 minus 14 equal to 0, 15 minus 2 equal to 3. 15 minus 13 equal to 2. So, here, when the total float equal to 0, the activity is critical activity. So, the activity 1, 3, the total float equal to 0, 3, 6, the total float is 0, 6, 8, the total float is 0, and 8, 10, the total float is 0. So, the critical activities are 1, 3, 3, 6, 6, 8, and 8, 10. Then the free float, total float minus the head event slack. So, 1 minus 1 equal to 0, 0 minus 0 equal to 0, 1 minus 1 equal to 0, 1 minus 1 equal to 0, 3 minus 0 equal to 3, 0 minus 0 equal to 0, 1 minus 0 equal to 1, 2 minus 2 equal to 0, 1 minus 0 equal to 1, 0 minus 0 equal to 1, 2 minus 2 equal to 0, 2 minus 2 equal to 0, 0 minus 0 equal to 0, 2 minus 0 equal to 2. So, these are all the free float. So, the critical path is 1, 3, 6, 8 and 10. So, what we calculated earlier. We take another example in the CPM network. A project schedule is given below. Draw the network diagram for the project. Find the earliest, latest time and the float of each activity and determine the critical path. There are 10 activities, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 3, 4, 3, 5, 4, 5, 4, 6, 6, 8, sorry, 4, 8. The timing are in days, 6 days, 8, 2, 4, 1, 5, 3, 2, 8 and 11. So, the network with the calculations are shown here. So, here all the values are shown, slack value, TE value, TL value, everything is shown here. Now, we use the various computation. First, we take the forward pass computation to calculate the earliest expected time. So, for the first event, the earliest expected time is set to 0. So, in the event circle, at the top of the circle, the event number is shown and bottom left, the TE value is shown, bottom right, the TL value is shown here. So, TE1 equal to 0, TE2 equal to, TE1 plus TE12 equal to 0 plus 6 equal to 6. TE3 is maximum of, for the third event, there are two incoming arrows. So, maximum of TE1 plus TE13 equal to 0 plus 8 equal to 8. And TE2 plus TE23, 6 plus 2 equal to 8. So, the maximum value is 8. Then, TE4, maximum of, there are two incoming arrows, maximum of, TE2 plus TE24 equal to 6 plus 4 equal to 10. TE3 plus TE34 equal to 8 plus 5 equal to 13. So, the maximum value is 13 for the fourth event. And TE5, so for there are three incoming arrows, again maximum of TE2 plus TE25 equal to 6 plus 1 equal to 7. TE3 plus TE35 equal to 8 plus 3 equal to 11. TE4 plus TE45 equal to 13 plus 2 equal to 15. So, the maximum value is 15. So, TE5, the maximum value is 15. And TE6, again maximum of, there are two incoming arrow. TE5 plus TE56 equal to 15 plus 5 equal to 0. TE4 plus TE46 equal to 13 plus 8 equal to 21. So, the maximum value is 21 here. And TE7, again maximum of TE4 plus TE47 equal to 13 plus 11 equal to 24. And TE6 plus TE67 equal to 21 plus 0 equal to 21. The maximum value is 24. So, TE value for the 7th event is 24. Then, use the backward pass computation to calculate the latest allowable occurrence time. So, for the last event, we fix TE7 equal to TL7 equal to 24. For the 6th event, TL7 6 equal to, there is only one outgoing arrow, TL7 minus TE67 equal to 24 minus 0 equal to 24. TL5 equal to, there is only one outgoing arrow, TL6 minus TE57 equal to 24 minus 0 equal to 24. TL4, so there are two outgoing arrow, TL4 equal to minimum of TL7 minus TE47 equal to 24 minus 11 equal to 13. And TL6 minus TE46 equal to 24 minus 8 equal to 16, the minimum value is 13. And TL3, there are two outgoing arrow, minimum of again, TL5 minus TE35 equal to 24 minus 3 equal to 21. TL4 minus TE34 equal to 13 minus 5 equal to 8. So, the minimum value is 8 here. And TL2, again minimum of, there are 3 incoming outgoing arrows. TL5 minus TE25 equal to 24 minus 1 equal to 23. TL4 minus TE24 equal to 13 minus 4 equal to 9. TL3 minus TE23 equal to 8 minus 2 equal to 6. So, the minimum value is 6. Then TL1, again minimum of, there are two outgoing arrow, TL3 minus TE13 equal to 8 minus 8 equal to 0, and TL2 minus TE12 equal to 6 minus 6 equal to 0. Then we calculate the slack of all the value, so slack equal to 0 for the first event, second event slack equal to 0, third event slack equal to 0, fourth event slack equal to 0, here slack equal to 9, 24 minus 15, 9, so here slack equal to 0, here the slack equal to 23 days. So, the event 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, they are the critical event, and the 5 and 6 are the non-critical event where they can be delayed by the number, slack number shown here. And the critical path here, there are two critical paths, 1, 3, 4, 7 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 7. So, this is the critical path is shown here. Now, we calculate the critical path using the CPM calculations. So, the CPM calculation, the total float and the free float are shown in the network, in the table here. The activities are 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 3, 4, 3, 5, 4, 5, 4, 6, 4, 7, 5, 6, 6, 7. The timing, duration in days, they are given here. TSI ESI equal to TIJ from the network, it is 00666888131313151. LCJ equal to TLJ from the network 688 13 24 13 24 24 24 24 24 and 24. Then the LSIJ equal to LCJ minus TIJ. So LCJ equal to the fourth column, TIJ equal to second column, 6 minus 6 equal to 0, 8 minus 8 equal to 0, 8 minus 2 equal to 6, 13 minus 4 equal to 9, 24 minus 1 equal to 23, 13 minus 5 equal to 8, 24 minus 3 equal to 21, 24 minus 2 equal to 22, 24 minus 8 equal to 16, 24 minus 11 equal to 13, 24 minus 0 equal to 24, 24 minus 0 equal to 24. Then ECIJ equal to ESI plus TIJ. So ESI equal to the second column, the third column and the second column, sum of these two, 0 plus 6 equal to 0, 0 plus 8 equal to 8, 6 plus 2 equal to 8, 6 plus 4 equal to 10, 6 plus 1 equal to 7, 8 plus 5 equal to 13, 8 plus 3 equal to 11, 13 plus 2 equal to 15, 13 plus 8 equal to 21, 13 plus 11 equal to 24, 15 plus 0 equal to 15, 21 plus 0 equal to 21. Then we calculate the total float. Total float equal to LSIJ minus ESI. LSIJ equal to the fifth column minus the third column. So 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0, 6 minus 0 equal to 0, 9 minus 6 equal to 3, 23 minus 6 equal to 17, 8 minus 8 equal to 0, 21 minus 8 equal to 13, 22 minus 13 equal to 9, 16 minus 13 equal to 3, 13 minus 3, 13 equal to 0, 24 minus 15 equal to 9, 24 minus 21 equal to 3. So the event activity with the 0 float, so 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, they are the critical activities. 3, 4 is a critical activity, 4, 7 is also a critical activity. Then the free float, which is the total float minus head event slack. So for the first activity 1, 2, it is 0, 1, 3, 0, 2, 3, 0, 2, 4, 3 minus 3 equal to 3. 2, 5, 17 minus 9 equal to 8, 3, 4 is 0, 3, 5, 13 minus 9 equal to 4, 4, 5, 4, 6, 4, 7, they are 0, 5, 6 equal to 9 minus 6, 9 minus 3 equal to 6, and 6, 7, 3 minus 3 equal, 3 minus 0 equal to 3. So according to the calculation, the activity with the total float equal to 0, they are the critical activities. The critical activities are 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 4 and 4, 7. And the critical path are two critical paths, 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 and 1, 3, 4, 7. These are all the critical path. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the operation research book. You can refer to the book for additional information in the PERT CPM computations. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification subject. We'll meet again in another video lecture in the PERT CPM. Until then, bye.